Let's also look at examples of what focal length does in terms of what viewpoint you want to capture. Here I'm showing two examples. Again, our two friends that have come visited us before. And here I've basically shown two images. This image was captured with a focal length of 18 millimeter on a 35 millimeter sensor, that is full frame camera. Distance to the first subject is half a meter, and distance to the second subject was 2 meters. In this case, I used a focal length 10 times as larger, 180 millimeter, again the same camera, and the distance to the first subject is no longer 0.5, but I moved 2.5 meters away, and of course that meant the distance to the second subject is also now 2.5 meters more, 4.5. Exactly the same scene shot by two different focal lengths, but the same camera. And you can notice that each one of them has a different impact. What this shows is that changing the focal length allows us to move back and still capture the entire scene. But of course, changing this form of a viewpoint also does change a perspective change. For example, these two scientists are appearing to be actually much closer than they are. They are actually almost 1.5 meter apart, but by looking at this image, you can't tell. They almost look to be sitting next to each other. One of the best ways to kind of visualize this is to see the vertigo effect. I recommend you look it up on YouTube. But this kind of scene perspective tricks are widely used in movies like the Lord of the Rings trilogy, where you could see Gandalf and Frodo sitting next to each other, but looking much different sizes. Of course, they're still approximately same human size, but in case Frodo looks much shorter. And this is exactly the kinds of tricks that were done in movies like this by basically moving farther away and using a high focal length lens to kind of show them to be different sizes. So this is the kind of tricks, again, are widely used in movie industry. But just by changing the focal length, we can actually change the perspective and the viewpoint.